Hello, this is Yogesh from IIC Bangalore. So in this video we will see the solution of the problem I provided you in the last video. So the problem was we had to find out this V output, that is this output voltage, and P dissipation across this Q, that is how much power is dissipating across this transistor Q. So in the circuit we have three devices and four few resistors and 15 volt battery. So these three devices are one is general diode, one is op amp and one is BJT. So we have the same procedure. We have to check whether these devices are operating in on condition or not. So for that we will assume these devices off and find out whether these are on or off. So we will start with this general diode and we will find out what we will assume it off and find out the voltage across this general diode. If the voltage across this general diode is greater than 6 volt, then this general diode will be on. It means that it will be doing its job. Now what is its job? Its job is to provide a regulated voltage. So in this case, since VZ equals to 6 volt, so if it is on, we can replace it by a 6 volt battery. But if it is off, we will make it open circuit. So let us find out the operating condition for this general diode by assuming it off. So we have assumed it off and we have disconnected this general diode from the circuit and we will find out voltage across this general diode. So let us do that. We have 15 volt battery here and the current which is coming from 15 volt will come in 6k and it will not go in this op amp because we are given that op amp is ideal and we know for the ideal op amp the terminal current, that is positive terminal current equals to 0 and negative terminal current also will be 0. So whatever current is coming from 15 volt battery, it will come in 6k and it will directly come in 3k. So 6k and 3k are in series, so easily we can find out this V plus. Let us find out a pipeline voltage division rule. Let us apply voltage division rule and find out this V plus, that is 3k by 3k plus 6k into 15, that is 3k by 9k into 15. So this will be 3 and 5. So I get V plus equals to 5 volt. Now I got this 5 volt. This 5 volt is less than this 6 volt. So since V plus equals to 5 volt is less than breakdown voltage of this Zener diode, now I can conclude this Zener diode will be off. It means that it is not doing its job. We will make it open circuit. So we will make it open circuit, that means we will disconnect this one from the circuit. Okay, so I got this 5 volt, this is also 5 volt and this is also 5 volt. So I got positive terminal voltage of this op amp is 5 volt. Now can we comment on negative terminal voltage of this op amp? Can we say virtual ground concept is valid here? As of now, we cannot say because we do not have information about the feedback here, whether there is negative feedback or not. We are given that op amp is ideal, but we are not given the information about this negative feedback. So for we have to find out negative feedback information, whether there is negative feedback or not. Now one thing here is, we know for op amp there is always plus V saturation and minus V saturation. So always there is supply. So anyways, this op amp will be on. We don't have to check for this device whether it is on or off. Anyways, it will be off. Now we will have to check for this device. This transistor is in on state or not. For that, we have to check this emitter junction, whether this emitter junction is forward bias or not. That means if VBE, this is emitter terminal, this is emitter terminal, if this VBE, we will find out this voltage. If VBE is greater than 0.7 volt, we can say then this diode, actually there is diode, PN junction diode there is. So if VBE is greater than 0.7 volt, this diode will be forward bias. It means that emitter junction will be forward bias and this transistor will be on. But if this VBE is less than 0.7 volt, then this diode will be reverse bias and this transistor will be off. So we will assume this transistor off and find out its operating condition, whether it is off or on. So let us do that. So we will make it open. We will disconnect this BJT from the circuit and find out its operating condition. So we have disconnected this one from the circuit. Now let us see whether it is on or off. So we found here we get 5 volt and here it is disconnected. This branch is disconnected and we knew this I equals to 0 in positive terminal of op amp and I equals to 0 in negative terminal of op amp. So no current is coming from here and no current is going in 1k and 2k. So 2k is having 0 current, so it will drop, so it will have 0 voltage drop. So this is 0 volt and negative terminal voltage is 0 volt. So now I can find out difference voltage for op amp. Difference voltage, that is Vd. Vd is V positive terminal voltage minus V negative terminal voltage. Here is 5 minus 0 equals to 5 volt. If Vd is 5 volt, that is greater than 0 volt, then we can say V output of op amp, let us say it is V over. Output of op amp, say V over, will be plus V saturation. This base terminal voltage is nothing but base terminal voltage. This is base, this is collector, this is emitter. So this base terminal voltage is plus V saturation and collect emitter terminal voltage is 0. So anyways, this base terminal, that is plus V saturation, is greater than 0.7 volt. So we can say base to emitter junction, that is JE, is forward bias. If JE is forward bias, we can conclude Q will be on. So if this Q is on, we will make it on by joining it in circuit. So we are making it on. Now this Q is on. Now we can apply virtual ground concept. So VGC will be applicable now. When VGC is applicable, we can say V plus equals to V minus equals to how much it is? 5 volt. So this is not now 0 volt. This is also not now 0 volt. It is 5 volt. Now we know the voltage across this 2K is 5 volt. Now I can find out the current across this 2K. Here, how much current is flowing? I can find out. So I equals to 5 by 2K. That is 2.5 milliampere. So I found that 2.5 milliampere is flowing in this K, 1K and 2K. Actually, this 1K and 2K are in series. Now I can find out V output. So V output is 1K plus 2K into current, that is 2.5 milliampere. That is 3K into 2.5 equals to 7.5 volt. So V output I got 7.5 volt. Now I have to find out P dissipation. P dissipation is VCE into ICE. That is IC. We know beta is very large. If beta is very large, it means that IB is negligible, almost equal to 0, and my IC will almost be IE, that is 2.5 milliampere. So I got IC, I have to find out VCE now. To find out VCE, I will be applying 1 KVL here to here. That is 15 volt minus 2K into current in this minus VCE minus V output. So let us do that. Apply KVL. We get 15 minus 2K into current in this, that is 2.5 milliampere minus VCE minus V output equals to 0. So 15 minus 2.5 into 2, that is 5, minus V output, we got 7.5 volt equals to VCE. So VCE is 10 minus 7.5. VCE I get 2.5 volt. Now I got VCE, I got IC. Now you can find out power dissipation. Just 2.5 volt into 2.5 milliampere. That is 6.25 milliwatt. So this is the answer for power dissipation.